All right, so what would you do if your husband was having a midlife crisis and suddenly announced that he wanted to become a cage fighter? She would videotape it, and now it's become a documentary called Under Pressure, Diary of a Cage Fighter's Wife. Please welcome Tamara and Todd Sturgis.
Hey, guys, welcome.
Thank you.
All right, so, Tamara, let's start with you. So Todd comes home. You guys are both truck drivers,
yes.
Right? Todd comes home, and he says to you what?
He says, hey, honey, I think I want to be a cage fighter. I think I want to do a cage fight. His best friend and I used to rent the DVDs and watch the fights, and his friend used to tell him, oh, you can do it, because he was a wrestler. You know, and I would just let him talk, think, oh, they're just doing their boy talk. And one day he said, I think I want to do it. I think I can do it.
Well, Todd, why?
Yeah,
why?
Yeah.
Well, there's...
Because you don't really look,
I know that you've trained now, so I take great risk in saying this, but I've not seen a lot of cage fighters in glasses.
No, well, they don't allow them in the cage, many of them may have
But what caused you to want to become a cage fighter?
There's two reasons I became a fan of the sport, and I wrestled, so I figured I could probably do it. And the other reason is self-defense. I had done wrestling, but I didn't know the other aspects of the sport, and I figured I'm in charge of my own safety, somewhat in charge of my wife's safety. We do go to, you know, bad areas as a truck driver, so kind of in a self-defense mode, I wanted to train the other aspects that I didn't know, so I decided to train. And then if I'm going to train, I wanted to test myself at least once.
And you wanted to do it before you got too old.
Yeah.
So what did you say to him when he comes home and says this?
I said, no, absolutely not. No way. We've been, at that time, we had been driving for almost a decade, and he hadn't been exercising at all. He had gained 40 pounds.
Yeah.
40 pounds. I mean, his breakfast of champions was chocolate milk and a donut, you know, like every day.
And I like that.
Yeah, so I said, there's no way. Have you seen these guys? You
yeah.
know, and I told him, he really was serious about it, you know, so I said, okay, I'll make a deal with you. Get into fighting shape, you know, train, practice, work out, get into fighting shape, and then I'll think about it. Well, it didn't work out that way. He got into shape by actually training to fight.
You, how does that feel, Todd, when you tell your wife, I want to do this, I want to be an ultimate fighter, and she says, look at you, look at you, you're a slob.
Well, that was kind of the way I got into it. I said, well, you know, I need to get in shape, and let me do this to get in shape. And
now, we saw you in, I think this is one of the first times you try it, and you are completely exhausted. You are worn out. And did you, when you watch that, are you just blown away by how out of shape he
yes.
was then?
When he did this, when he was serious and wanted to do this, I said, I have to get this on tape. No
right.
one's going to believe this, you know. So I went down with him to the gym on his first day, and I had never seen him. I didn't know him when he wrestled. I met him at the end of his wrestling career. So I never seen him do anything like this. And when I saw how exhausted he was, I didn't know if he was hurt. I didn't know what was going on. It was just pure physical exhaustion from every head
to toe. So you decided to tape this, and it's turned into a documentary.
Yes.
And how does that feel to have this quest in your life on tape for everyone to see?
I wish I would have come off more like a tough guy during it, you know. But it just showed everything. It started kind of as a home movie, so, you know, I wasn't worried about it. I thought it was cool. My family members and friends could see my first day. And I believed I was going to get in the cage, but not 100% positive. So I didn't mind it because it was just a whole movie at the time. And then as the film progressed, it showed everything from start to finish. So I was kind of proud of it. I actually didn't mind the first part because I did get into shape.
There is one part that's especially touching for me. It's when you have to go pick him up at the gym because he's hurt himself. Let's take a look at this.
I knew it was just a matter of time. Sure enough, I got a call from Dave. Todd was hurt and I needed to come pick him up. When I got there, he seemed okay to me. I was mad as hell, so I told him to drive himself home. When he got home, it was obvious he was seriously hurt. He had a cracked rib and a concussion. He wouldn't let me film him, so I just set the camera down and let it roll. I couldn't understand why anyone would want to do this.
How'd you get home?
You were mad as hell. And then make him drive himself home, and he's seriously hurt. How did you guys, your relationship is kind of strained at this point.
That was the only time in our life where we had not been on the same page with what we were doing in life. And as it started, I just was going down for fun to videotape him. And as I started seeing it get really serious and the injury that was involved, I just wasn't supporting him anymore. And when stuff like that would happen, I wasn't there for him. You know, I wouldn't support him. And the way it manifested from a home movie into a documentary is at that point when he did get hurt and I was just, why does anyone do this?
Right.
I had to go talk to other women and say, you know, why? How do you watch this? How do you watch your husband or loved one do this. And I started interviewing others, and it kind of manifested into a
documentary. What did you learn from them?
I learned that some of them are, they support their husband because their husband wants to do it. They're not, you know, super happy about it. It wouldn't be their choice for their husband, but they support their husband. And I found some family members don't watch, they don't go, they don't watch the tapes, they don't want anything to do with it, they don't even want to know about it. And others, their mothers are in the audience going, kicking! Yeah.
And what did your family think of all this, Todd?
My family has always been a competitive family, so either football, wrestling, so they didn't like the cage fighting aspect of it, but just because it's just something since I've been like 7 years old, they back me.
You went into the first fight, your one and only fight,
yes.
And you actually won that fight, which was pretty incredible. So we see you here, and you actually win this fight, and it's all over with. You're excited, you're exhausted, and you decide, now after that win, what did you decide to do, Todd?
I decided to retire.
So
I
decided good.
To just let the sport go on, and I'm still a fan of the sport, and so I just like to watch the sport. I do try to work out when I get a chance.
Smart to retire on top.
Yeah.
We want everyone to know, by the way, that Under Pressure, you can see it tonight through Sunday out of the Jubitz Travel Center. Two showings, by the way, 7 to 9 o'clock. There's information on your screen right there, or we have it linked on our website. Just go to katu.com. Guys, thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Glad you retired from that. All right, does your team...